From pickup trucks to luxury cars, there have been some serious automatic transmission design failures over the years, plagued with everything from recalls for sudden accelerations and exploding gears to transmissions locking up and engines exploding. It could feel like there are too many components in an automatic transmission that can go wrong. But of all the issues you can run into, having a doomed automatic transmission is perhaps one of the worst. It doesn't matter if it's an 8-speed automatic or 12. Eventually, a major component is going to grenade and leave you stranded. And while most cars have 100,000 miles on their odometer before trouble start, certain automatic transmissions suffer from birth defects right from the get-go. Whether it's due to poor engineering, materials, assembly techniques, or any combination of the three, there are several fatally flawed automatic transmissions that you should avoid at all costs. Luckily for you, you clicked on this video, because today you're gonna learn about the 10 worst automatic transmissions of all time. The Ford Focus. By now, it's a well-publicized issue that Ford's PowerShift dual-clutch automatic transmission has caused problems for owners of 2012 through 2016 model years of its Ford Focus cars. Now nearly 2 million customers stand to get a repayment for their trouble in a class action lawsuit settlement currently before the U.S. Court of Appeals, and as a result, Ford will be forced to pay billions in blood money. The first incident of transmission failure occurred 8 months after the transmission was put into production, when a driver in a 2012 Focus with only 500 miles was T-boned due to a catastrophic transmission failure. The victim was stopped at a parking lot exit, waiting to enter a thoroughfare. Engine idling, with his foot lightly on the brake, suddenly his Ford accelerated forward into the traffic lane, as though someone had pressed the accelerator pedal to the floor. It took a 45-mile-per-hour T-bone to the driver's side door. The driver reported that his elderly wife suffered severe heart bruising from the seatbelt, and that he figured that he was saved by the airbag. Other common issues arising from Ford's faulty PowerShift automatic transmission include a shuddering feeling when accelerating from a stop, like someone who can't feather the clutch properly on a stick shift, followed by a rough first to second upshift that again sends a vibration throughout the vehicle. But if you think that's all, guess again, because you'll also have to deal with slipping, bucking, jerking, transmission hesitation while changing gears, premature internal transmission wear, delays in downshifting, and in some cases, sudden or delayed acceleration. It's basically the worst transmission ever built. The Jeep Cherokee. During its debut, the 2014 Jeep Cherokee was noteworthy for showing off the world's first 9-speed automatic transmission, produced by German pioneer ZF. The compact unit, which also debuted in the Land Rover Evoque, weighed 17 pounds less than the outgoing 6-speed automatic, and delivered fuel savings of up to 16%. Unfortunately, this transmission has a nasty habit of murdering its drivers. Despite its advanced technology, the ZF 9-speed automatic transmission has been problematic to say the least, with reported issues including sudden lunges from unexpected downshifts, no kickdown when merging on a highway, front axle vibration in low gears, and complete mechanical failure. In mid-April of 2019, Jeep recalled 1.1 million vehicles equipped with ZF's automatic transmission because, according to the automaker's recall notice, some drivers exited their vehicles without first selecting park, ultimately causing the cars to roll away uncontrollably. On the unusual mushroom-shaped gear shifter, a driver presses and holds a button and pushes the shifter all the way up to sit their car in park, after which the shifter centers itself again. But Fiat Chrysler said that the Jeep shifter design didn't provide drivers with sufficient feedback for them to know what gear the car was in, and so some drivers just left the vehicles in neutral before exiting the car. And due to this catastrophic failure, actor Anton Yelchin paid the ultimate price. While the Star Trek actor was leaving his home and clearing the security gate, he put the vehicle in park, got out, and left the vehicle. Anton Yelchin's 5,000-pound Jeep Grand Cherokee then experienced sudden and total transmission failure, causing it to roll backwards and pinning him against the gate with such force it bent the metal. The Ford Explorer. Transmission failures and problems are unfortunately very common with Ford Explorers. The cost of a repair can be enormous. The most common transmission problem found in Ford Explorers is outright failure. Symptoms include a blinking OD light, slipping gears, difficulty shifting, and sudden rapid deceleration of the vehicle. Many customers report transmission failure after only 30,000 miles of normal driving. The cost of this repair could be as much as $4,000, perhaps even higher if the repair is done by a dealership. Customers have also reported higher than usual RPMs being required to shift the vehicle from first to second gear, followed shortly by gear slippage and total transmission failure. The good news is that often only the transmission's wiring will need to be replaced, but this repair can still cost upwards of $7,000. Ouch! The Honda Odyssey. Despite being an extremely popular car brand, Honda has experienced numerous problems with their Odyssey model, with its main focus being its terrible automatic transmission. The troubled timeline of the Odyssey transmission problems can be seen early on in the company's history. Honda began marketing and manufacturing the Odyssey in 1994, creating a smaller minivan for the middle class. Since 1999, Honda has made a bigger version of the Odyssey in North America to fit bigger families and more items. Unfortunately, 1999 was when the transmission problems began. Citing issues with the transmission's durability in the 4-speed automatic minivan, a Honda spokesperson stated that the problem with the 4-speed models were characterized by a faulty bearing, which would break apart and send fragments of metal into the passageways of the transmission, causing it to shift unintentionally. Honda tried to remedy the issue by including a 5-speed automatic transmission in the 2002 model, but that transmission experienced problems as well, with of course drivers citing reliability problems. The 5-speed models were generally damaged by the wear and tear of the third gear clutch. The clutch material would explode, which would scatter bits around inside the transmission, causing erratic shifting once again. Drivers would succumb to slipping or not being able to shift between gears while driving at high speeds. Furthermore, the second gear reportedly could overheat and break, causing the transmission to lock while driving. The Volkswagen Beetle. If only the Beetle today had remained as lovable and durable as the old ones, it probably would have made on this list of the deadliest automatic transmissions at all. Unfortunately, everything that we mentioned about the Volkswagen Jetta is also true for the modern-day Beetle, due to its sharing nearly all the same substandard engines and fatally flawed transmissions. Since the Beetle tends to have more owners who want an automatic transmission than the Jetta, naturally it has a higher defect rate overall. Common problems experienced by Beetle owners with an automatic transmission include unusually harsh shifts from first to second, second to third, third to fourth gears, extremely harsh downshifts, gear slipping, flared shifts, shuddering and shaking of the transmission occurring at high speeds, overheating, and total transmission failure. Over 20% of Beetles traded in either have an engine or transmission issue that is so bad that it required replacement. That may not seem like a big deal until you take in the fact that the average Beetle is traded in with only 60,000 miles. That's barely middle-aged in today's car world, where a quality vehicle can last past the 200,000-mile mark. The Nissan Pathfinder. More and more new vehicles are using a continuously variable CVT automatic transmission rather than a conventional hydraulic transmission. Why, you ask? Somewhat like a bicycle chain, a CVT's heavy-duty drive belt runs between groove pulleys with hydraulic actuators, allowing the gear ratio to vary infinitely within a range, seamlessly. CVT's deliver tangible fuel savings, but more importantly for manufacturers, the units are simpler and cheaper to produce. The Nissan Pathfinder has come equipped with a CVT transmission for 15 years, and for 15 years straight, these cheap transmissions have proved themselves to be ineffective at best and fatally flawed at worst. Common complaints include violent shaking and shuddering, difficulty accelerating, overheating, and total transmission failure at high speeds. Early examples saw that CVT snapped their low-cost metallic belts after just 1,000 miles. Tons of other Nissan owners have also known the scourge, even after the transmission manufacturer took steps to improve reliability. Sadly, the transmission continued to fail regardless. As a result, the 2014 model made it onto at least 10 least reliable car lists, with buyers reporting transmission problems and rattling noises. Other common problems include an erratic fuel gauge and engine noises caused by slackened timing chains. The starter relay is also known to fail, leaving you high and dry because your car won't start. Not to mention transmission fuel leakage, which can again leave you stranded in the middle of nowhere. According to Consumer Reports, the vehicle also doesn't handle that well either, and the running boards are more of a hindrance than a help. The Volkswagen Jetta. Some cars offer a variety of engines and transmissions. In the case of the Volkswagen Jetta, it can make a striking difference between a rock-solid car that will be light on your wallet and a rolling lemon that can easily bankrupt you. The problem is that millions of Jettas, past and present, feature automatic transmissions. It's believed that the new 8-speed automatic transmission used in the 2018 and 2019 Jettas is one of the worst automatic transmissions known to man. The faulty transmission has reportedly caused oil to leak from the cars, as well as emitting noises drivers have described as grinding, scuffing, scraping, and growling. These less reliable models collectively make up to 80% of the Jetta's total trade-in volume. Attorneys suspect that a possible defect in the torque converter is behind the problems. The Corvette 305 California. federal emissions requirements in the 1970s took a big neutering knife to American muscle cars. And at that time, no car bled more than the Corvette. The worst of it came in California, where stricter state regulations required that the barely adequate 350 cubic inch small block in the 1980 Corvette be replaced with a wholly inadequate 305 V8, putting out 180 horsepower of pure shame. On top of that, the California Corvette sucked its pitiful horsepower through the straw of a torque-snapping 3-speed automatic transmission that gave the Corvette acceleration comparable to a 30-year-old Ford Taurus. The Kia Rio. While some lemons can be avoided by opting for certain engine and transmission choices, others are just plain inevitable. The Kia Rio has remained the worst entry-level car when it comes to lemons for nearly 15 years now. The hard reality for the Kia Rio is that as it ages, it eventually becomes far less reliable than any other competitor, with the main issue being its automatic transmission. What makes matters worse is the greater need to have it serviced. While most automakers have moved on to timing chains or timing belts that can last at least 90,000 miles, the one for the Kia Rio must be changed every 60,000 miles, which was the industry norm well over 20 years ago. The Rio is a lemon for another reason. The newest models seem to be supporting the idea of changing the transmission fluid every 100,000 miles, which personally we find a bit optimistic. If you do want to make the Kia Rio a keeper, our advice is to cut that fluid change regimen to 50,000 miles, and always get the timing belt changed before it hits 60,000 miles. A replacement engine or transmission is incredibly expensive on these vehicles, given what they offer as daily transportation. Well guys, those are the 10 worst automatic transmissions of all time. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, if you like what you see at the channel, subscribe and put post notifications on. You could also follow the channel on Instagram at ModernMuscleYT. Also, if you guys like the channel, want to support it more, want exclusive content, go to patreon.com/modernmuscle and be a patron. I'm Jeff from Modern Muscle, and I'll see ya next time.